channel. In the last couple videos of the series, we've been tackling trees, binary trees to be more precise. Today we are going to solve a couple problems that tackle binary search trees specifically. If you have no idea how BSTs differ from normal binary trees, feel free to check the video linked in the card above. Okay, so one of the problems you might be given during an interview may start with a sorted array. And what you're asked to do is transform this sorted array into a height-balanced binary search tree. You see, if the height-balanced condition wasn't in the question, all the trees in front of you would be valid answers for the given array. However, adding this condition implies that only this tree is a valid solution for the given array. Now, to tackle such a problem, all we need to do is lay out the characteristics of the data provided to us. First, the array is sorted, meaning that this array represents the in-order traversal of a certain tree. Second, the tree we are looking for is a BST, meaning the left subtree of the root is smaller than the root and the right subtree of the root is bigger than the root. So, the most straightforward way to build a balanced BST here is consider that its root is the middle element of that array. The left part of the array will constitute the left subtree and the right part the right subtree. Then the same logic is repeated on each subarray individually, meaning that the exact left node of the root will be this middle element, and the exact right node of the root, or the root to its right subtree, will be that one. We keep doing this until the tree is complete. Now, one way to implement this solution is by using recursion, and our recursive method will take a starting and an ending index, which, at first, these will be the minimum and maximum delimiters of our array. Inside this method, and with the help of these delimiters, we will need to fetch the middle element and set it to be the root of the current tree slash subtree we are dealing with. Then, the left subtree of this root node will be deducted from the left subarray, which will be similarly constructed with the help of the same method. And the right subtree of this root node will be made of the right subarray elements. As with all recursive methods, do not forget your breaking condition. And finally, do not forget to add a couple conditions at the start to account for edge cases. Okay, in this first problem, we were asked to generate a binary search tree given an array. However, what if we were asked to generate this BST from the head of a sorted singly linked list? So, the only difference now is the type of data structure provided to us as input, and tackling this new problem is straightforward, as we can use the same exact approach. Therefore, we will start with a couple checks to handle a null head or a list containing a single element. Then we will attempt to retrieve the middle node of the given list, just like we previously did, and create the root node of the current tree slash subtree with the help of the value stored inside it. Now, the sublist representing the left subtree of the root will start at the initial head node, and the sublist delimiting the right subtree of the root will start at the next node of the middle element, because we just used the middle one to be the root of the current tree we are dealing with. Okay, now, the real difficult part lies in the implementation of this getMid method. You see, to retrieve the middle element of an array, we just calculate the index. But how are we going to do that given a linked list? Well, you could traverse the list once to count the number of elements stored inside it, then divide this number by 2, and use it to retrieve the middle element. Or, if you've watched our two pointers technique introductory video, you can create two pointers, a slow and a fast one. The slow pointer will hop one node at a time, and the fast will hop two nodes at a time. By the time the fast pointer reaches the last element of the list, the slow pointer will be located exactly at the middle element. Now, the implementation of this getMidHelper method will differ a bit from what we previously saw. You see, the slow and fast pointers will remain the same, and the basic building blocks of the previous implementation will all remain there. However, we need to also keep track of the parent, or the element preceding the middle element. Because you see, if we directly return the middle element without cutting off the list right before that element, the left sublist or subtree represented by the head node will still be taking into consideration the whole list. The links to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.